Hi folks, this is Mario Pitsch with the ninth video of the TillyWiki development environment series. So we are finally at the stage where we can fork TillyWiki 5 from Jeremy. TillyWiki 5, search it, which is the upstream repository now. So to create a writable repository, we need to fork it. So click the button. So now it copies everything from Jeremy's repository to our writable repository, which has the alias name origin. Yeah? So I clone or I copy the URL. Then we open a new folder. Sorry. Go to git tilly and create a new folder tillywiki5. TillyWiki 5 and we select it. Yeah. Now we clone the TillyV URL, which downloads the whole content, yeah, starting from the first commit that Jeremy pushed several years ago. Yeah. So we are basically able to recreate the whole or every single version of TillyWiki which Jeremy ever pushed. It needs some time, and once it's finished, we will get the directory structure here. Okay, and it automatically activates the master branch, which is good, and we are at origin. What else do we need? Now we need to connect to the upstream repository, so we copy the URL. And we create a new remote which is called upstream. Okay, paste Jeremy's URL. Yeah, there you need to take care that you really copy the right one, because afterwards you would have two times the same access. But now we have where is it? Upstream. That's funny. Okay. It needed some time in the background. I don't know. I didn't experience this. Okay, but now we have two versions, so we can contribute, or we can upload to origin, and we can download from upstream. Yeah? So if we create a new file, let's say asdf.txt. Oops, what did I do wrong? I first have to create a new branch. But that's not really a problem, because Git doesn't know about ASDF yet, so it says untracked. Yeah? So as long as you don't commit something to a branch, it is not part of the branch. Yeah? So we could say delete file here, yeah, without any consequences. Yeah? As long as you didn't push something that is committed, you are safe to undo everything. Yeah? But once you committed it, you need to create a new commit to delete something. Yeah? So that's really important. First, create a new feature branch. New feature branch. Yeah, it should be a new feature. I don't know, X, Y, Z or something. Yeah, so give it a good name. Then we track it, we commit it, give it a message. Then it wants to know our username and email address. Okay, now we commit it again. And now we are able to push it. Yeah? We can try to push to upstream, nothing will happen, so it won't work because it is not allowed. It would create a new branch, but say okay, now there should be the dialog, the login dialog. Okay, oops, sorry. Okay, copy the password and the username. Say login. And you see it says the remote directory permission is denied, which is clear because this is upstream. Yeah? If we push to origin, everything should be fine. It's a, oops again, okay. Hi. Ah, maybe because the first time didn't allow it. Okay, now. So it pushed to upstream, to origin, and it automatically detects this new branch and allows us to say compare and create a pull request. I click the button, but I don't create a real pull request, just to show you how it looks like. Now we are creating a pull request against master with our new feature branch. So here we need some, let's say, clear information what the pull request wants to change and why. So this is really important, and it should only contain the absolute minimum of files that have to be changed. So I don't know, 3, 4, 5 different files. So because this makes the review much easier. So if you push, or if you create the pull request with 20, 25 files, there is a high chance that it will never be included. Because it's really hard to create the review. So the smaller the changes are and the more defined they are, the easier it is to get it into the core. So this is important. We know this workflow already from the other videos. And in the next video, we will have a closer look how to build different editions. So there are a lot of existing editions, and now we will go to the command line and create the new feature branch and test something. Let's say build new editions. So what we did connect we did fork Jeremy's repository. We did download, we did create the link to the origin repository. We did create the link to upstream repository so that we can make updates afterwards, and we push to origin just to test that everything is okay. And as I said, in the next video, we will build an edition. Have fun.